Hello, welcome back. What we're going to talk about today is counting in chemistry. And counting in chemistry is very much like counting in any other thing. Let's say we are talking about the phrase one dozen. Now, most of you are very familiar with that phrase. If I say, hey, I've got a dozen pennies, how many is that? Did you just talk to yourself out loud? That's funny. Anyway, if I've got a dozen pennies, that's 12 pennies. How about if I have a dozen eggs? How many eggs is that? It's 12. If I have a dozen chickens, 12 chickens. A dozen cars, 12 cars. And so it doesn't really matter what we're talking about. So one dozen items is the same thing as 12 items. Doesn't matter whether we're talking about coins, chicken, eggs, or cars. A dozen is 12. Now, in chemistry, we have to talk about things, I don't know, on a slightly different scale than we do when we're talking about buying a dozen eggs. Because in chemistry, if I take a swig of water right here, I just put about 1 times 10 to the 23rd or so, even maybe a little more than that, molecules of water into my mouth. Now, it's crazy. That number's enormous, 1 with 23 zeros after. I mean, you can't imagine the scale of that number. And so when we talk about counting in chemistry, we have to be able to count numbers like that because that's the scale of life. Is huge, huge numbers. And just like we did when we talked about the AMU, the atomic mass unit, we said, oh, it's really hard to keep that track of that 10 to the minus 27th or whatever it is, so let's make up this unit called AMU. Somebody just made up a unit and they called it the mole. And what is a mole? It's exactly the same thing as a dozen. If you have a dozen items, you have 12 items, doesn't matter what they are. In fact, you can have a dozen water molecules and then you have 12 water molecules. Well, a mole is exactly the same thing, but it's made for chemistry. And if you've wondered what that picture in the top of the slides is up there, that is my mole, I guess, right over there, pointer right there. That's my mole. So it's an antisocial creature, it lives underground and is blind, and it's the mascot of chemistry. So it's the chemistry equivalent of a dozen. And what we say is that one mole of items, doesn't matter what the item is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of those items. Now, normally we're talking about atoms, molecules, things like that, but sometimes we're talking about eggs, chickens. Can we talk about eggs and chickens in those scales? We can. It doesn't make much sense, but we can. So if we had a mole of eggs, what would we have? If we had a mole of eggs, we'd have one mole of eggs is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd eggs. What if we had a mole of chickens, right? 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd chickens. Okay. A mole of cars, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd cars. Just as if we'd had a dozen is 12. A mole of carbon atoms, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd carbon atoms. A mole of CH4 molecules, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of them. A mole of DNA, it's 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of them. It's just a way of counting things. So now I can say, hey, look, I just drank myself a mole of water. Much easier than to say I just drank myself 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of water. That's all we use it for. It's just a way of simplifying all these calculations that we're doing on a scale that we do in the lab. All right, so here's just a quick question. If someone had 6.02 spots on their body, what would they have? Would they have 10 to the 23rd moles of moles? Would they have one mole of moles, 6.02 moles of moles, or just too many spots? Well, if 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of anything, is one mole, so that means 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd spots is one mole of spots, and spots on our body are moles, so there's my bad attempt at humor, one mole of moles. I'm not sure why all my slides were down there today, but they were, so we'll fix it. And back to moles again. So we can use that conversion, that one mole of anything is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd anything, as a conversion between moles and counting, right? Just like we used a dozen. A dozen isn't directly telling us how many we have, right? If we want to figure out how many we have, we take however many dozen we have, we multiply it by 12, three dozens. 3 times 12 is 36 eggs. Same thing for moles. It's a way of counting indirectly. If we want to know exactly how many we have to multiply by 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. But what we're going to do when we talk about moles is we're going to use them as conversions. Okay, so how do we use things as a conversions? Remember, we start with our starting stuff, we write our ending stuff at the end, and then we put our little conversion factor in the middle. So here the question is asking how many moles of forks in 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd forks. Now, of course, we should be able to answer that off the top of our head. 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of anything is 1 mole, so we have 1 mole of forks, but let's do it mathematically and methodically. We're gonna start over with our 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd forks on the left. And on the right, we want moles of forks. So there we go, left and right. We think there's a conversion factor that's going to get us from one to the other. Now remember, what's more important, the number or the unit? Right, the number. No, the unit. The unit is more important. If you don't get the unit right, it doesn't matter what your numbers are. So we're going to try to cancel the units first, then we're going to figure out our numbers. So if we're trying to cancel forks in a numerator, we need forks in a denominator. One on top, one on bottom cancels out nicely. And then if we want to get moles of forks in the numerator, we got to put moles of forks in the numerator. Now we ask ourselves, what's the conversion between moles of forks and forks? And we know that 1 mole of anything is 6.02. So 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of them. So which number is attached? Right? 1 mole of forks. The 1 is attached to moles. Is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd forks? It's attached down there. Remember, don't memorize that the 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd goes on the bottom, goes on the top. Don't memorize that. Memorize numbers, stay attached to their unit. If you do that math out, you should get yourself a lovely 1. Now, of course, we have to do significant figures. We have 3 significant figures here. It turns out that this value I gave you is only with 3 significant figures, so we do have to take that into account. So we get 3 significant figures at the end, and you get 1.00 moles of forks. You can look up this number online. You'll get different numbers of digits. It's called Avogadro's number, by the way. I forgot to say that. Avogadro's number. Yeah, named after Fred, right? No, named after Avogadro. Amadeus Avogadro, who discovered a lot of these things about counting in atoms and molecules. All right, so here's another one. How many moles of spoons in 1.2 times 10 to the 24th spoons? So we're going to start off with our starting value over here, 1.2 times 10 to the 24th spoons. And then we're going to go over here and we want moles of spoons. So what are we going to do in between? We're going to write ourselves a conversion factor. We think there's a conversion factor that gets us from one to the other. And what's that one going to be? Well, if we're trying to cancel spoons, one on top, one on the bottom. Spoons down here, and we need moles of spoons up here. What numbers go in there? Well, we know that what's the relationship between moles of something and that something? Moles of spoons and spoons. 1 mole of spoons is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd spoons. Numbers stay attached to their unit. 1 mole of spoons is 6.02. times 10 to the 23rd spoons. If you do that math out, you should get 2.0 moles of spoons. 2 significant figures here because we only had 2 significant figures in our starting information. All right, so that's how we can use that number, Avogadro's number, as a conversion between moles of something and the count of it. Just like we use dozen, we multiply by 12 to go from a dozen to a count. 4 dozen is 4 times 12 is 48. But you know, it doesn't just work for spoons and forks and chickens and eggs. It works for chemistry too, otherwise we wouldn't use it. So let's do some more problems. How many xenon atoms are in 2.0 moles of xenon? So we've got 2.0 moles of xenon. Now your professor comments, did you leave off the E on mole? And I did, because that's the most common way that chemists write mole. It's just as M-O-L instead of M-O-L-E. You know, that one letter saves us so much time. So that's what we do. We're going to say, hey, there's probably a conversion factor that's going to get us to our final unit here of xenon atoms. Now, that's what the English says. But it turns out elements on the periodic table are never units. They're always helpers. So my xenon is a helper. And if my xenon is a helper, helpers go after the unit. And so I'm going to say atoms of xenon. So elements and molecules are never units. They're always helpers. Okay, that's an important thing to keep track of. They're never units, they're always helpers. All right, so let's go back and solve our problem. Numbers first, units first. Units first. So we need to cancel out moles of xenon, so one on top, one on the bottom, looks like that. And then what we want to get? We want to get atoms of xenon, so that's got to go on our top. Atoms of xenon looks like that. What's our relation between atoms of xenon and moles of xenon? Atoms and moles. Something and moles is always how many? Where does the one go? One mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. Right? The mole is the container. Atoms are counting each individual one. If we multiply that out, we get ourselves what we had on the last page, which is 1.2 times 10 to the 24th atoms of xenon is what we have in 2.0 moles of xenon. Two sig figs in my answer, because I had two sig figs to begin with. All right, next one. How many moles of lithium in 3.01 times 10 to the 24th atoms of lithium? We can do this one a little faster, because it's pretty similar to the one we just did. Now, where do I want to put lithium? As the unit or as the helper? It's an element, it's always the helper, and so I'm going to say atoms of lithium. Put that on top there. We know there's a conversion factor, and we're trying to get to moles of lithium. Again, leaving off the E. We want atoms to cancel, and so it's got to go on the bottom. One on top, one on the bottom. It cancels just like that. We're trying to get to moles, so we better put moles up there. What's our relationship between atoms and moles? One mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. So again, you can see even in these two problems, if you memorized that 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd went on the top or went on the bottom, you'd get it wrong about half the time. Numbers stay attached to their unit. All right, if you do that work out, you get yourself with three significant figures, 5.00 moles of lithium. And obviously, we're contriving these examples, and so that's why our numbers are all nice and round. In the real world, they're not going to be so round, but it's always nice to start off with easy ones. So 5.00 moles of lithium in 3.01 times 10 to the 24th atoms of lithium. So here's a question for you to try. How many moles of grains of sand are on the beach if the beach contains 1.4 times 10 to the 14th grains of sand? And by the way, that's an approximate number of the grains of sand on an average beach. I did look it up. So take a moment, try to solve that problem, and see what you get. All right, we're back. Here's a question for you. Multiple choice tests, the bane of existence, right? I don't like multiple choice tests. I don't think anyone likes multiple choice tests. But oftentimes, we can eliminate answers in multiple choice tests just by thinking about a problem as opposed to solving the problem. If we know a little bit, right, this is 1.4 times 10 to the 14th grains of sand. If we know that one mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd of something, then is this less than a mole or greater than a mole? And hopefully you came up with that 10 to the 14th is less than 10 to the 23rd, and so this is less than a mole. So whatever my answer is needs to be less than 1. Well, the only answer is less than 1 is C. So we actually solve the problem without doing the math. But let's set up the math and make sure we understand how to solve the problem. We've got 1.4 times 10 to the 14th grains of sand. And we want to know how many moles of grains of sand we have. These are long units. They take a little longer to write out, so I'm going to leave myself lots of space here. Grains of sand on the top means grains of sand on the bottom to cancel out. I want moles of grains of sand on the top. What's my relationship between moles of something and that something? Right. 1 mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. And if you do all that math out, you get yourself the 2.3 times 10 to the minus 10th moles of grains of sand. So a very small number of moles in that case. But right, 10 to the 14th, that's a huge number. I mean, 10 to the 9th is a billion, 10 to the 12th is a trillion. So you're talking 100 trillion grains of sand. And it's this really, really tiny amount of moles. So that's how we count in chemistry. We count in moles. And the only reason we do it is it makes our life easier, because instead of saying, oh, I've got 14.75 times 10 to the 26 of these things, I can say, oh, you know, I've got 18 moles. And it's just much easier to be able to talk like that and do math with those numbers. And it's just like a dozen. And what we're going to see as we go forward in doing this math, if we can do it and talk about a dozen doing it, then we can do it and talk about a mole doing it, and the math works out the same. So we're going to use that analogy quite a lot as we go through these calculations. I look forward to talking to you more. Bye.